students, now I am going to discuss another dimensionless terms. So in the last session, last class, we discuss about Reynolds number and Froude number. Third number is Mach number. Okay, so Mach number, this is denoted by Mn. So what is Mn? Mn is equal to Fi by Fc, root under Fi by Fc. This already we have discussed also in Froude property. So we know Fi is nothing but rho L square V square. Okay, also Fi is equal to, see here, viscous force, gravity force, compressibility force plus pressure force plus surface tension force. Okay, so Fi by Fb, Reynolds number. Okay, Fi by gravity force, Fi by Fg, that is Froude number. Fi by Fc, that is Mach number. Okay, so this is, I have already given there. Now we have to find out what is Fc. This compressibility effect is related with the terms bulk modulus, that is delta P by del V by V, volumetric stress. Direct stress by volumetric strain is known as bulk modulus. Okay, this has no unit because dV by V, it is dimensionless terms. So it is equal to pressure. So pressure is compressibility force by area, this having no unit, and K is bulk modulus. So Fc will be equal to, area is nothing but L square K. So let us substitute in equation. Therefore Mach number will be equal to, Mach number will be equal to root under rho L square V square by Fc will be equal to L square by into K. So L square will get cancelled. This is V square, okay, root under V square by K by rho. So it is V by K by rho, root under K by rho is V by C. So Mach number is also equal to V by C, that is fluid velocity by sonic sound velocity. Sound, okay. Detail about this one, if Mach number is less than 0.3, then we are calling it incompressible flow. Okay, and if Mach number is equal to 1, that is called sonic flow, that is V and C will be the same. If Mach number is greater than 1, that is called supersonic flow. So Mach number decides the types of flow, and that is used for missile, rocket launching, all those space area we are going to use Mach number. So this is about the Mach number. Application also I have discussed, their classification also we have discussed, their derivation also I have discussed. Okay, so as I told you, there are 5 dimensionless terms. Out of 5, we have discussed 3. One was Reynolds number, second one was Froude number, third number was Mach number. Other 2 numbers are not so important, but let us know what is that number also. Okay, so from this equation, another number comes, that is number 4, that is called Euler number, it is denoted by En. So En is equal to, that is Fi by Fp. Okay, now we know this one is rho L square V square. Okay, now Fp, pressure is nothing but, we know pressure is equal to force per unit area. Okay, so let us call it as pressure force. So Fp will be equal to L square into P. So it is L square into P. So this equation is known as Euler equation. Applications for which Euler equation, that is, see here, pressure force. So pipe flow, it is also used for pipe flow. Applications of the Euler number is in pipe flow. There we are finding out the pressure difference, and by the pressure flow is there. Okay, so that type of number, dimensionless term, is known as Euler number. Number 5, that is last, that is called Weber number. Weber number, that is denoted by Wn. Okay, so Wn is equal to, as I told you, see this one, Fi by Fp is Euler number and Fi by Fs is Weber number. By this way you can remember very easily, that is Fi by Fs. Okay, Fs, Fi we know, rho L square V square, by Fs surface tension. So surface tension we know, sigma into L, that will be surface tension force. So that is sigma into L. So this is Weber number and this is applicable. Where we can apply this Weber number, that is for surface tensions of capillary, blood movement, okay, like that. Capillarity, blood movement, okay. So that type of examples are there due to surface tension, okay. So surface tensions due to effect, that will be taken care by Weber number. So we have already discussed all the 5 dimensionless numbers. In the last sessions, we have already derived Reynolds number and Froude number. Third number was Mach number. So Mach number is nothing but Fi by Fc. I have already told you, Fi is rho L square V square, that we have already proved. And that also equal to algebraic sum of viscous force, gravity force, pressure force, compressibility force, and surface tension force. Okay, Fi by Fb is Reynolds number, Fi by Fg, Froude number, that we have already discussed. Now square root of Fi by Fg, okay, square root of Fi by Fc is called Mach number. Okay, so Fi we know, rho L square V square, rho L square V square here. And what is Mach number? Since compressibility force is related with the bulk modulus. Okay, so bulk modulus, that we have already discussed in the fluid property also. So bulk modulus K is direct stress by volumetric strain. This has no unit, okay, no unit, because it is dV by V. So direct pressure, this is pressure, is force per unit area. So Fc into La is L square into K. Okay, putting this value, we will get V by C, that is fluid velocity by sonic velocity or sound velocity. If Mach number is less than 0.3, it is called incompressible flow, and it is equal to 1, then it is called sonic flow. If it is in between 0.3 to 1, that is called subsonic flow also. And a Mach number is greater than 1 up to 5, it is called supersonic. And if it is greater than 5 up to 9, it is called hypersonic also. Okay, that also I have already described, super hypersonic. So hypersonic flow, remember, this is incompressible, these are compressible flow. So Mach number decides the flow, as a compressible or incompressible. That is used in missile, rocket launching, okay, even we are going to use this in turbines, pumps also. Number 4 is Euler number. 3 important numbers we have already discussed, Reynolds number, Froude number, and Mach number. 4th number is Euler number. Euler number is Fi by Fp. So Fp is nothing but pressure into area. So putting that value, it will give us Euler number, that is applications of this Euler number is in pipe flow. Number 5 is Weber number. Weber number is Fi by Fs. Okay, so surface tension force, surface tension into area, putting this value, we will get this equation. And this application for this one is, let us call capillarities effect. There, in capillarities effect, we are putting Weber number. Okay, rest of the thing I will discuss in next class. Thank you.